Well, last couple of days I can easily say that I'm living in Greenland and not in Greece, because like temperature is super low, minus 6 Celsius or something like 20 Fahrenheit, so I couldn't find a better occasion to shoot my video for top 20 fragrances for winter 2018 to 2019. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Agelos, aka Greek Perfume Aficionado, and this is my perfume vlog. I hope you enjoy the content you see here, so in that case, please don't forget to subscribe and turn on the post notifications in order to stay up to date with any future video upload. Without further ado, let's start with some fragrances that unfortunately couldn't make it to the top 20 list for several reasons, not something specific or particular, but for several reasons couldn't fit in the top 20. First honorable mention is a thrilling perfume, a vintage perfume, something that is not so easy to find nowadays, only in some auctions on eBay or maybe in some fragrance groups. I don't know many people who want to sell actually this perfume. And this is none other than Bal à Versailles from Jean Desprez, and one of my favorite amber, vintage, civet, floral, a gorgeous concoction. And look at this mini bottle, it's I think 4 ml. Look at the artwork. This is super strong, super heavy, floral, animalic amber perfume, one of the most historical amber perfumes ever created. And isn't it gorgeous? Unfortunately, couldn't make it, maybe due to the fact that it's super rare to acquire the vintage formulation. Second honorable mention is a fragrance that I really adore again, but unfortunately again discontinued and super expensive and difficult to find nowadays. And it's none other than A Bit Rouge, but the Extrait de Parfum version. A fragrance that I really like also to layer with A Bit Rouge dress code. The Eau de Parfum, the first edition. I think the other editions are totally fine as well. So this combo, this beautiful patchouli, floral, A Bit Rouge was actually a fragrance that was marketed to men, but it was considered a little bit androgynous, so it's a totally unisex fragrance, both of them, the dress code and the Extrait de Parfum, also the Eau de Toilette or the Eau de Parfum or the Cologne from the past. So yes, my second honorable mention, this masterpiece, unfortunately again, I think it couldn't fit this list because of its rarity. And yes, it's a gorgeous fragrance. If you enjoy A Bit Rouge in general, just go for it. If you find it for a good price or retail price, I know it's very difficult nowadays, but just pull the trigger. So let's move on to the actual list, the 20 or 20 plus fragrances, because some of my suggestions are layering suggestions. And at number 20, we find another gem, another discontinued gem, a fragrance that was marketed to women, but it's totally unisex, and it's Christian Dior Midnight Poison. And this is the first edition because you see the silver stem. The second edition had a gold stem here. Not many differences. It was actually the same perfume, not something like a huge reformulation or something like that. Just a change in packaging and presentation, in my humble opinion. So this one, I beg Christian Dior, if they're listening, and LVMH, please, if you don't want to recreate the formula or relaunch this fragrance, just sell the formula somewhere else to a niche company, because this is an exceptional perfume, and I'm sure if any niche company right now, if they launch this perfume again, this formula, they would sell out immediately. So this perfume has a very beautiful orangey opening, tons of masks, absolutely tons of masks, and you have a gorgeous jammy rose with patchouli, with some ambers. It's incredible, incredible, simple and incredible. Number 20, Midnight Poison from Christian Dior. Next one, number 19, and definitely that low on the list because it's discontinued, unfortunately, again. Designer again, one of the most beautiful, woody perfumes I ever put my nose on. Gucci Pour Homme 1. I can't speak highly enough of this perfume. It's gorgeous. I'm sure all of you have heard about this perfume or smelled this perfume. I used to wear this perfume when it was launched. I was very lucky and happy that back in the day you could easily purchase this perfume. Of course, it was on the expensive side. Don't let this mislead you that it's a designer. It was very expensive. Also, Gucci Envy was very expensive back in the day comparing to other designer perfumes. So this one is dry woods. It's incense, it's ambers. It's very, very, very dry. If you enjoy dry, woody perfumes, this one is made for you. But thankfully, there are some replacements for this perfume, and this is very good to hear because these ones are being sold right now for hilarious amounts on eBay. The one I can propose, because I've heard about Bentley perfume, I think that it supposedly smells like Gucci Pour Homme, but I haven't put my nose on it, so I can't suggest something that I haven't put my nose on. So the one I'm suggesting, it's not cheap by all means. It's from Le Labo and it's Vetiver 46. Vetiver 46 is very, very close, and I never heard someone mentioning this. It's very, very close. I can say it's like 90 to 92% close to Gucci Pour Homme. Has this olibanum smell comparing to the incense smell here. You have the cedar wood, you have the dry wood, you have the signature musk base from Le Labo, which you can find in almost all of their perfumes. And the outcome is quite close to Gucci Pour Homme. So just give it a try if you have a Le Labo store or a big department store. I'm sure they're carrying it in Lafayette in Paris or in Barney's or Bloomingdale's, I don't know, in the United States. So just give it a try. You will get like 90% similarities, 90 to 92% similarities with Gucci Pour Homme. At number 18, we can find one of my favorite and very affordable leather fragrances, one of the most historical leather fragrances. It's none other than Knize 10. And this is the Golden Edition, and the Golden Edition is the closest you can get to the vintage Knize 10. This is quite affordable. This is 125 ml, so you will have this for a lifetime because it's very, very potent, lasts for like forever. So you have a blend like a Cuir de Russie, but it's a little bit more on the masculine side. It's very strong. You will definitely make a statement when you are wearing it. Probably suitable, more suitable for the mature guys that are watching these videos, but just give it a try. Affordable, extremely well-smelling leather perfume. I think it's quite easy to get your hands on, so just give it a try. Number 18, Knize 10 Golden Edition. Moving on to number 17, and we are talking about a fragrance that actually, it's one of the fragrances that made me love perfumes and collect perfumes and deal with perfumes in general. And it's none other than M7 from Yves Saint Laurent. So this is the infamous amber bottle, and this is the first edition of this perfume. There was another formulation after that, which was the same shape, clear bottle with an amber sticker. There was another one afterwards in the typical Yves Saint Laurent square bottles. Then we had the M7 Oud Absolu, and I think as I recall, as I smelled it, they were super close to this first edition. So, if you find Eau d'Absolu, it's almost the same idea. You don't have probably some materials that have been restricted, not necessarily natural raw materials, but also some synthetic raw materials. There are always restrictions with IFRA, so they cut some ingredients, they put some others, so you have some differences in the formula. Not a big deal. The recent formula, I told you I smelled, it's totally fine. It was totally fine. So if you like amber, woody, powdery, a little bit citrus in the opening, and floral in the heart notes, this is made for you. This is absolutely made for you. It's one of the best if you like these notes I mentioned. Number 17, M7 Yves Saint Laurent. Moving on to number 16, and we have my second favorite from the house of Amouage, and this is Epic Men. I'm sure most of you are aware of this fragrance. Just my two cents, this is one of the best strong, a little bit animalic, woody leather fragrances. It's dry, it's also super spicy. It's kind of the same category as M7. I see some similar, I would put them both in the same category. Spicy, a little bit powdery, a little bit sweet, ambery. Although this is more into leather, not so much into amber. You have ambers as well here, but not so much as in M7. I can definitely speak for hours about this fragrance. I love this fragrance, but we have another 15 fragrances to mention. So number 16, Amouage Epic Men. At number 15, we have a combo, a layering suggestion of two perfumes. I absolutely adore both of them. One was mentioned in my top 20 fragrances for fall video. It's Ensemitique d'Orient from Guerlain. And the other one is again from the house of Guerlain. It's a vintage, but you can easily get the newest version. It's not a big deal. And I'm talking about this masterpiece. Look at this presentation. You have this beautiful little box, and inside you have Mitsuko. And this is obviously the extrait de parfum, or parfum. And I need to smell this one, it's gorgeous. Oh my god. So the layering purpose here is to use Ensemitique. It's very aldehydic, it's very incensey, smoky, rosy, and at the same time you are using this masterpiece to give this oomph with the bergamot, with the peach, with the oak moss. It's one of the best chypre perfumes of all time, of course, Mitsuko. So the combination of incense, smoke, aldehyde, rose, you get from Ensemitique d'Orient, and of course the vanillic base, vanillic amber base from Guerlain, the signature, perfect vanillic base. When you combine this with bergamot, peach, and oak moss, you can get from the extrait de parfum from Mitsuko, you get a regal result. It's out of this world. It's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And it reminds me a lot of Diaghilev from Rosa Parfum. So, just try it if you can get your hands, not necessarily on a vintage Mitsuko. So if you have Mitsuko from an extrait de parfum Mitsuko and Ensemitique d'Orient, just try it and let me know in the comments down below if you find the same similarities with Diaghilev I personally find. So number 15, Ensemitique d'Orient and Mitsuko. Moving on to number 14, and we have another leather perfume, but it's not so potent in leather. It's from the house of Memo Paris, and this is African Leather. And to be honest, this is my favorite from their leather line. So, Memo African Leather. It's definitely a leather perfume, but it's more transparent, more spicy, with spices. When I say spices, you get a lot of cardamom and a little bit of nutmeg. You obviously have some woody and musk based notes and ambery based notes. It's a very, very, very nice blend. Very nice blend for a leathery but not so potent in leather perfume. So if you enjoy spices, fresh spices, a hint of leather in the background, you just go for this one. Try it. I'm sure you'll love it. I haven't met a person yet who doesn't love this fragrance when they smell it on you or when they wear it. Number 14, Memo Paris, African leather. Number 13, and it's a fragrance I also mentioned in my top 20 fragrances for fall. I absolutely, absolutely adore. Unfortunately, I hoped it would be higher on the list, but there were some other heavy hitters that had to be included. I wore this a lot during fall time, and it's none other than Incident Diplomatique from the house of Jouat. And I really, really, really love this perfume. You have the most animalic smelling vetiver with patchouli, with some musks, with some hints of orange peel, the opening. It's just gorgeous. Just gorgeous. Absolutely my favorite from the line of Jouat fragrances. I adore this fragrance, although I love many other from the recreations. Incident Diplomatique is just amazing, guys. Just amazing. Number 13, Incident Diplomatique and Jouat. Patchouli is one of my favorite raw materials and notes in general. So I couldn't make a list of my top 20 winter fragrances without adding absolutely Chanel. And this is Coromandel. This is the Eau de Toilette. But I'm definitely positive that Eau de Parfum works fine as well. What can I say about this? You have this earthy patchouli, great patchouli. I don't know where this oil comes from, but this is an exceptional patchouli. You have this sweetness, this ganache, chocolate sweetness, and of course, beautiful citruses in the opening, some woody notes in the background, some musks. It's incredible. One of the best from the line of Les Exclusives, number 12, Coromandel. I'm sure one of the fragrances on my list you all are aware. And at number 11, one of the best amber fragrances, modern amber fragrances, but blended to perfection from Maison Francis Cuxian and perfumer Francis Cuxian, of course. And this is none other than Grand Soir. So, Grand Soir, simple yet gorgeous. Simple, saying simple, they replace citruses with some other molecules which are very pleasant at the opening. You can just go straight forward to ambers and musks and vanille or vanillin or whatever. So, some molecules for the welcoming, and then you get a beautiful, beautiful blend of tonka bean, amber. It's labdanum, some other ambers. You have vanillin, you have vanilla. You get a very sweet, ambery, a little bit musky blend. Blended to perfection, as always, from Francis Cuxian. I'm sure most of you enjoy your sweet amber perfumes. Just do yourself a favor and go try this fragrance. You will definitely remember my suggestion. It's gorgeous. And one of the best compliment getters in my collection. Absolutely. Number 11, Maison Francis Cuxian Grand Soir. So finally, my top 10, or to be more accurate, not 10, it will be like 12 or 13, because I have some layering suggestions as well, as I mentioned at the beginning of the video. So without further ado, at number 10 spot is Songes d'un Bois d'été. And it is from the house of Guerlain. So this line, the Le Désert d'Orient, I think it's discontinued or it's going to be discontinued, and some of these fragrances will be replaced, or actually all of these fragrances will be replaced from other fragrances in the Les Absolus d'Orient line. This one particularly will be replaced with the Bois Mystérieux, I think that's the name. I haven't smelled it yet, so I couldn't say if it's similar, reformulated, the same, you know, it's maybe in the future I will have something to say about that. So, Sons d'Ambois d'Été, one of my favorite, super potent, woody, masculine, very masculine, resinous. You have this sweet mirror, and I don't know if there is, I can detect a little bit of opoponax. So you have this mild and very delicious sweetness from the sweet resins. You have some spices like cardamom and bay leaf, and oh boy, it's amazing. It's very, very intense, woody fragrance with a nude accord as well. I think it's a must try. So I hope Bois Mystérieux, the replacement of this one, will have the same awesome smell as this one. Number 10, Sons d'Ambois d'Été. At number 9, we have my favorite from the Armani Privé line. My signature scent for quite a few years. It's more like a sandalwood with an intense wood and woody accord. Some rose, some hints of rose, saffron. You have a very beautiful saffron opening, and we also have a cat crying at the garden at the ground floor of my building, so okay. A very creamy sandalwood, delicious wood, woody, rose, saffron combination. Beautiful fragrance. My favorite from the Armani Privé line, and this is none other than Oud Royal. At number 8, we have one of my favorite niche houses, and this is Nichanet and Fan Your Flames. This is the 15ml travel spray. It was kind of introduced to the public at Excense last year in Milan, so I hope they will release, if they haven't released them yet, it's very convenient. 15ml of your favorite fragrance from Nichanet, you can't go wrong. So, Fan Your Flames is a very boozy, coconut-flavored tobacco, if that makes sense, with patchouli as well, some musk, some mulberry notes, some woody notes. It's just delicious. I really, really feel so great whenever I smell and I wear this one. I really can't get enough of this juice. It's very nice and very appropriate for cold winter days. I really, really adore it, and I will definitely upgrade to a big bottle as well. But these guys right here, these small guys, are very, very convenient for your travel, because you know Nichanet are very potent, all of their fragrances are very potent. So with 15ml you are set for, let's say, a week if you travel somewhere, maybe more. So yes, 15ml, it's great. Number 8, Nichanet Fan Your Flames. So number 7, we have another one from the house of Maison Francis Cousin, and it's Oud Satin Mood. This is the Extrait de Parfum version. There is an Eau de Parfum as well that came earlier. I really, really enjoy this one more than the Eau de Parfum, and I will explain myself. You have, again, a very beautiful, a very dense and a very round violet, powdery, a little bit woody, with the addition of the oud accord, of course, which is again a little bit calm. It's not like a very strong oud accord, but this composition right here, although it serves that's the same formula, give or take, from the Eau de Parfum edition, this one is a tad more leathery, and it makes it more wearable for me, because the first one, it was super sweet. This one also has a lot of vanilla, but the first one with the violet and the powder and the vanilla and rose, of course, it was a little bit too sweet for me. This one is a little bit more leathery, and it makes it more wearable in my humble opinion. Please be careful with your sprays right here, because if you spray a lot, you may choke a lot of people, and maybe you will be a little bit cloying. Number 7, one of my favorite from the house of Maison Francis Cousin, and this is Oud Satin Mood. Number 6, a strong leather fragrance or perfume, and this is from the Spirit of Dubai, and it's called Maidan. Maidan is gorgeous, but it's super strong. Another one, another fragrance which is obviously on the expensive side, but one or two sprays and you are good to go for almost the whole day. And this is incredible. This is, guys, this is a really incredible juice. Incredible. If you love leather fragrance, you have to put your nose on this one. It's super strong, black leather, you know, black leather jacket with dry fruits, with pine woods. You have this resinous, piney, woody, tons of wood, some, not so many florals, but many woods. I'm sure if you love leather fragrances, you won't get disappointed. This is incredible leather fragrance. Number 6, Maidan from the Spirit of Dubai. Moving on to number 5, and oh boy, this is an attar, and this attar is created by a dear friend of mine from Sultan Pasa. I'm sure most of you are aware, because he is very well known in attar creations, and this is called Irisoir. It's obviously a fragrance around iris or oris root. The compositions of Sultan Pasha are always super complicated and super animalic, and wood and floral, of course. He creates some very beautiful attars, but this one is absolutely my favorite from his creations, and I will explain. I don't want to describe this fragrance in more technical terms or notes and this stuff. I will just say that this one, if there was a possibility that we had an edible orris root spread, like a marmalade or something like that, that's how it would smell. It's buttery, sweet, fruity orris with ambergris, of course. Sultan Pasha uses a lot of ambergris, natural ambergris, but this one is extremely floral, yummy, delicious, buttery, rooty orris with sweetness, with fruitiness. It's just incredible. If you like sweet gourmandise, but not something very cloying, this is not cloying, this is buttery sweet orris root, and it's out of this world. Number 5, Irisoir from Sultan Pasha Attars. At number 4, we have actually two fragrances, because it's a layering suggestion. I told you about it in this list. We would have lots of layering suggestions. So, it's from the house of Dusita. And we have, initially, look at this presentation, by the way, for a travel atomizer, okay. And we have, first fragrance is Oud Infini. Okay, and the second one is Fleur de la Lita. So, when I initially smelled back in 2016 Oud Infini, I was a little bit sad, because Pissarra Movidzani, the perfumer, is a friend of mine. I couldn't bear Oud Infini. Although I love oud, I love civet, I love andolic notes, it was just too much for me. So, look what's happening right now. This one is maturated, like for the last 2 years that it was, the formula was initially created, and it's maturated, and all these super andolic and animalic notes are a little bit calmed down, at least to my nose. But at the same point, oud, civet, regardless, the beautiful rose de mai and neroli notes that are included in this formula, it's again a little bit too much for me. So, when you apply Fleur de la Lita, which is a fresh floral, a beautiful bouquet of exotic and white florals and musks, White Mask, Clean Mask, phenomenal fragrance. It's one of my favorite from this line. So when you apply this one on top of this one, you get the animalic notes. There are also andolic notes here because of the white flowers, but Fleur de la Lita has as a top note galbanum. So this galbanum gives this greenness and this freshness and covers a little bit the very strong andolic and animalic nuances and facets you get from the civet here. So you have a very beautiful green blanket on top of this super animalic fragrance, and when you get over this animalic opening, you have the florals, you have the rose de mai, the white florals, the neroli and the woods and the musk, and trust me, this combination is amazing. So if you have these ones or you can find them in store and layer them, please let me know, because I found this combination, this layering suggestion, just great. It's really a divine combination, trust me. Number four, Oud Infini, Fleur de la Lita, both from the house of Dusita. So we have the last three, and without further ado, number three we have from the house of Serjoff, and this is Alexandria 2. And Alexandria 2 is by far my strongest and longer lasting and longer projecting fragrance in my whole collection. It's just out of this world strong, you know, it's super strong. And at the same time, one of my favorite fragrances in my collection, because this is beautiful, beautiful, my favorite from the Oud Star collection. This is a powdery oud, wood, floral. You have some lavender and rose, sandalwood. It's it's great. It's great, and you can't go wrong, because you have a great smelling fragrance, a great smelling fragrance, and a super potent fragrance. So it's money well spent, because 50 ml will last you like forever. Enough said, I can't do a winter top 20 list without adding this. Serjoff, Alexandria 2. Number 2, and this is none other than Portrait of a Lady from the house of Frédéric Malle, and perfumer is Dominique Ropion. And I really like this perfume house because they mention the perfumer on the sticker, which is very important. Sometimes we say this brand, that brand, but we don't know the perfumer, and the perfumer needs to get a credit. Portrait of a Lady, except from the fact that it is a very, very strong fragrance as well, a little goes long way. This blend is just amazing. You have beautiful rose, and I think there is lots of rose absolute here. And you have musks, you have, of course, this exceptional incense and patchouli accord and musk, as I told you, and some faint fruitiness, resins, of course, tons of resin. It's very resinous and a little bit balsamic, but it's mostly an incense, patchouli, rose with musks. I would strongly suggest, if you haven't put your nose on this fragrance yet, and you are a rose, incense, wood, patchouli lover, just try it. Just order a sample. I don't know if you have any store close to your location which carries this perfume. Just try it. If you love rose, incense, musk, patchouli, just go for it. It's incredible. Number 2, Dominique Ropion for the house of Frédéric Malle, and we have Portrait of a Lady. And finally, my number 1, another layering suggestion. Kemi Tempest, the spray Extrait de Parfum Edition. The second one in this layering suggestion is from the house of Fragrance Dubois, and it's Sarah Oud. And I'm really happy this perfume house that they provide their compositions in 15 ml small travel bottles, because they are really expensive, and the ratio euro per ml, it's almost the same as the 50 or the 100 ml bottles. So if you want to try fragrances and buy fragrances from this perfume house, you can just go as I did with the 15 ml, because they are very strong and they will last long, and you don't need to invest in 50 or 100 ml bottles, which are super expensive. So Kemi Tempest. I explained that this is absolutely my favorite fragrance, my favorite acquisition for 2018. I really, really used a lot, and this is super strong, but I use this every season. Summertime, springtime, fall, winter as well. This will always be in my fragrance arsenal. Let's talk about this layering. Kemi Tempest, it opens fresh, citrusy floral with LME resin, which is one of the best fresh and not so potent resins. And you have the funkiness of the wood, some woods, some musks, some ambers, incredible. Fragrance du Bois, Sarah Wood, the Desert Wood. You have a beautiful grapefruit, sweet grapefruit opening with saffron and lots of real wood. And guys, this combination, the fresh floral resinous opening with the sweetness from the grapefruit and the spiciness, the sweet spiciness from the saffron, and the funkiness from the combination of the two woods here, are, guys, it's incredible. I can't express how much I love this combination, and I will be totally honest with you. It was accidentally created last year when I visited the Jovoir perfume store in Paris, and I had already sprayed Fragrance du Bois, Sarah Wood, and then I forgot that I sprayed this one here because I had like tons of fragrances on my arms, and I forgot that I applied this one, and then I took it was the Attar back in the day, the Extrait de Parfum wasn't released, and I took the bottle of the Attar and I applied on top of this one, and as a good friend of mine said, I created a monster, but it was in a good way because the combination is heaven. So that was it. Thanks again for watching. I hope this video was not too long. I hope you enjoyed. Please leave a comment down below if you like my suggestions or you have something else in mind. You have to suggest something, a fragrance that you wear during winter time and you absolutely adore. I'm all ears. Please let me know. So till the next one. Cheers.